In this video, I will demonstrate the process of enhancing bitten and deformed nails with polygel. We are dealing with very difficult nails this time. We have bitten nails and cuticles and a very small nail bed. I will start with cleaning the skin of the nails and around the cuticles. The cuticle is basically absent. From the middle of the nail with the machine in forward mode, I start filing towards left. I place the bit between the cuticle and nail bed, slightly touching the nail bed. I am making as much possible space by filing the skin, as I am dealing with a small nail bed. I usually do the left side of 5 nails in forward mode, then I switch to reverse mode and file the right side of it. When dealing with bitten nails, you will notice that the soft cuticle you would normally have turned into dry, thick skin. With the help of the drill bit, I defined the thick skin, and now I will cut it with a nipper. I will buff the nails. The skin is quite thick and dry, not only around the cuticle, but also on the tip of the finger. So I will smooth it out with the buffer. You can use this technique when you are performing a manicure as well. The final result of smooth skin will please the client. I am spraying antiseptic spray because the cuticle is locally red and has some cuts, so I want to sanitize the skin. Also, the antiseptic dries the nail so it can replace the dehydrator. I apply the bonder. I will use the same plastic tips I used for the refill video class. Now, I'm going to match the tips with the nail size and shape. The tip fits perfectly on the nail bed, covers the sides, and has enough space to create the apex. The tips should match the nail size perfectly. We see how well they match by placing it close to the cuticle. Usually, the index and ring finger fit the same size tip, and the middle finger fits one size bigger. The final step in nail prep is the application of base gel. Cure for 60 seconds. With a scraper, I scrape a small amount of polygel as we have a small nail bed, and we aim for short, square nails. Another coat of gel will follow. Now, we are creating the frame of the nail, and we do not want it to be very thick. Place the form on the nail with the whole body. Gently press on it and push it upwards to the cuticle, not reaching it. I take the brush and gently smooth the product between the form and the cuticle. With tapping movements, I blend the transition from natural nail to the artificial nail. Cure for 10 seconds and then remove the tip. I'm moving to the next finger. I recommend a short length when enhancing bitten nails, especially if it is part of rehabilitation treatment. If you aim for a long-lasting result that will help the nail bed to recover and eventually become normal, the length should be grown gradually. Bear in mind that people who bite their nails are anxious. They don't look after the nails and are not bothered by the bad looks of the nails. For them, it's easy to pick the nails and pull them off in case they notice any lifting or breakage. So, quality is what you are aiming for, and you should communicate all this to your client. Cure for 10 seconds and then remove the tip. Using the same technique, we apply the forms on the rest of the nails. Missed to spread the product from underneath the nail on the pinky, and that caused the gel to stick to the skin. Shortly, you will see a close-up on how to fix this, but try to avoid doing this mistake as it will give you a hard time to file. Using a cleanser, I remove the sticky coat. Now, I will roughly file the nails without stopping too much at this step. I'm focusing on the area around the cuticle, the sides, and the free edge. I'm applying a small quantity of gel to give a bit of thickness and strength to the nail. I am focused on applying a little bit further from the cuticle. I need more gel towards the middle, sides, and the free edge of the nail. When you work with a small quantity of polygel, you will notice that it tends to drag and stick more to your brush. It can be from two reasons. One, your gel is warm or the temperature in the room is warm. And two, Your brush needs cleaning. I suggest cleaning it with acetone or brush cleanser. Also, you might want to keep the polygel in the fridge if the AC goes off at night in the room where you work and it becomes hot. That's optional, but I find it helpful. Following the same technique, I am moving the next fingers. I use a scraper to remove the excess product on the free edge. Cure for 60 seconds. Using a cleanser, I remove the sticky coat. I start filing with a drill the area around the cuticle on all 5 fingers. The drill is in forward mode, and I file from left to right, turning the finger in the position that's comfortable to file. I proceed to filing the sides, the body, and the free edge. I file gently and gradually because there is a little product on the nail. I remove the sticky layer to file the gel from underneath the nail, otherwise the gel will get stuck between the drill blades. I will have to stop and clean it, and this will slow the process down. As well, it's not recommended to turn on and off your machine too often, as this will shorten the lifespan. I'm comparing the size of the nail with my left index finger. Using the same technique, we file the rest of the nails. Upturn the finger and finish shaping the nail from this radius. I am checking the C-curve. Both nail sides need to be at the same level. Avoid narrowing the nails. This will weaken the sides and the nails will break easily. The only recommended shape for the first three treatments is square. Oval, almond, and round are strictly not recommended as they have a higher chance to break due to thin and narrow nail sides. I am adjusting the length to match my left middle finger. This is the nail where I missed to spread the product underneath the nail. You can easily notice how the product stacked on the nail. The drill doesn't fit to file close enough. I will use the pear-shaped drill to fix the situation because the tip of the drill is dull and I cannot hurt the skin if I go deeper. double-checking if there is any skin left to cut after the hands have been washed. I highly recommend washing the hands after the final filing. I am super satisfied with the results. I will apply a nude color on the nails. I apply the color and I help myself with a thin brush to apply the color right around the cuticle and the sides. I cure for 10 seconds for the color to fix and not run or leak. I apply the second coat on all five fingers and I cure for 60 seconds. I mix the glitter with the top coat and I apply it with the oval brush. Last step, I apply the top coat and I cure for 60 seconds. Don't forget to apply cuticle oil once you made sure that the top coat is cured and no adjustments are needed. Thank you for watching!